Let us consider influence line diagrams for truss members. So consider a N-type truss as shown in figure. Now we have to construct influence line diagrams for various members. That means for if the truss is subjected to moving loads, then first of all, to find out the forces in members due to the moving loads, we have to construct influence line diagrams. Now first let's consider influence line diagrams for top chord members. So member U2, U3, let us consider this member, and the each panel, this is a 6-panel truss, each panel, length of each panel is A, total span is 6A, the height of the truss is H. Now this, when unit load is moving from one end to the other end, we have to calculate force in the member. And this variation in force is to be drawn along the span of the truss. Now, if member U2, U3 is to be considered, that means we have to calculate force in member U2, U3 for various positions of unit load. Now, to find out the force in the member U2, U3, let us use section method. So, establish the relation between the force in member U2, U3 and position of moving unit load from one end to the other end. While considering the positions of unit loads, let's consider positions at the joints only, because the generally our basic assumption is loads are acting at the joints. So if to find the force in this member, let's take the section 1-1. So let us take this section 1-1. Passing through maximum 3 members, and it should cut the member in which the force is required. Let us take a section 1-1 which cuts maximum number of members 3, because we have 3 equilibrium conditions. And again, that section should cut the member in which the force is required. So you know very well how to use the section method to find out the forces in the members of trusses. Now, if we take a section passing through this section 1-1, passing through member U2, U3, then this, you take a moment about a joint such that the moment due to the forces in other two members must be equal to 0. That means if we take moment here about L3, then moment due to force in this member and then force in this member is equal to 0. So only we will have the moment due to the force in the member U2, U3 and one of the reaction. One of the reaction means, if suppose the force is on the left, so unit force is here. Then, so you take, so member U2, U3, use summation M about L3 equal to 0 and consider RHS, because load is on left. Apply this equilibrium condition for right hand side. So and on the right hand side we have the reaction, vertical reaction. So whenever there is a unit load at a distance x, so this we know, this is L minus x divided by L. This reaction, say this is V1 and this V7 is reaction at joint 7, say this is x upon L. So this reaction is x by L. Now, see, while taking moments, see moment about this, by using section method, considering right hand side, so this is anti-clockwise. That means the moment due to the force in the member should be clockwise. So that means the direction of force should be towards right. So this is towards the joint, means nature is compression. Nature is compression. So this is F U2 U3, F U2 U3 into H, distance, perpendicular distance, force into perpendicular distance must be equal to, this is equal to X by L into this distance. This is 4A into 4A. From L3 the distance of reaction is 4A. Now what is this? This FeO2O3 is equal to X. Now the applicability 0 less than equal to X less than equal to A. So means here we have to consider left joint of the section and right joint of the section. You find out the ordinates and this is a linear variation. So we will plot the straight lines. So this X is, now you put A into 4A divided by L is 6A into H. So ordinate you get is 2A by 3H. And nature is, this is compression. Nature is compression. So let's take compression positive and tension negative. Then this is when unit load is on the left of section, and next when unit load is on right of section. So once you consider left position and then right, if X is equal to 0, ordinate is 0. Now consider this, take again moment about L3 equal to 0. So FeO2O3 into H equal to, now left hand side, let's consider left hand side. So moment due to this is clockwise. So moment due to force must be anticlockwise. So again nature remains same, that is compression. So FeO2O3 into H. So this is force reaction L minus X upon L into distance is 2A. Into distance is 2A. Now this applicability is from this 2A to 6A. So 2A less than equal to X less than equal to 6A. So this is the applicability of this equation. Means we have to consider the position just right of the section here. Now if unit load is here, what is the ordinate? So that means this FeO2O3 into H, L is 6A minus X, let us consider X equal to 2A divided by 6A into this 2A. So you take H on this side divided by H. Now what is this? Force now becomes 2A, this is 4A into 2A. So this A gets cancelled. Okay, let's keep as it is now. This is 4A into 2A divided by 6A into H. So this, actually this is the maximum ordinate of ILD. This is maximum ordinate of ILD. If we draw the influence line diagram, say U2, U3, ILD for U2, U3. So this ordinate we have calculated. This ordinate here it is 0. Then we will get this ordinate. It remains straight up to this. And then X equal to 6A. So this you will get 0. So this is 2A by 3H. And what is this ordinate? This ordinate will be A gets cancelled. And this will be 4A upon 3H. 4A by 3H. So this is 4A by 3H. So ordinate is more and this is maximum, and then as X increases, ordinate reduces linearly, and finally X equal to 6A, the ordinate becomes 0, this is plus, this is ILD. Now one more thing we observe here, so if you write like this 2A into 4A divided by 6A, 1 upon H, so this is nothing but moment at opposite joint. divided by H. Moment at opposite joint divided by H. Means for top chord member, without doing all these calculations, we can directly obtain the ILD, or maximum ordinate of ILD will occur at the opposite joint of the member divided by H. Moment at the opposite joint divided by H. That is ML3 divided by H. Because for member U2, U3, L3 is opposite joint. So in this way, now we can construct ILD for remaining top chord members. So either do the calculations by taking section and using equilibrium conditions. So let's consider member U1, U2, top chord member U1, U2. Let's consider this member. What is the opposite joint of this member is this. Consider the triangle U1, U2 as the base of the triangle. Apex of triangle is the opposite joint. Now here, so maximum ordinate of ILD will occur at opposite joint and is given by so F U1 U2 equal to moment at opposite joint, moment at opposite joint divided by H. Now this moment is calculated. That means that we know if we have a simply supported beam subjected to a single concentrated load, if this is A and B, total span is L, then we know moment is this. And this is given by WAB upon L. And W is 1, so AB by L. So same formula is used here also. So opposite joint, when unit load is at opposite joint, left distance A, right distance B divided by span. So we get the moment at that joint. So A into B divided by L, W is 1, AB by L. Same thing here, opposite joint, what is the opposite joint? U1, U2. Opposite joint is L2. So ML2 divided by H. What is ML2? L2 is here. So this distance is A, remaining phi A. So this is A into phi A divided by 6A, that is span, and H is there, divided by H. So now this ordinate is phi A upon 6H, and nature is compression. So you draw the ILD for member, say this is U1, U2. So opposite joint is here, it's a triangle only, and this ordinate is phi U A upon 6H, positive compression. So this is ILD for U1, U2. Now let's consider next member, U3, U4. So member U3, U4. U3, E4. What is the opposite joint? L4. Opposite joint is L4. And we know this is a triangle only. And this ordinate is given by so again, maximum ordinate will occur at opposite joint and is given by F U3 U4. F U3 U4 equal to opposite joint is ML4 divided by H. And this ML4 is A into B divided by L. A is 3A into B is 3A again divided by 6A. So 3a into 3a divided by 6a into h. So this is 2. So this is 3a upon 2h pump ratio. So this ordinate is 3a upon 2h. So this way we can construct ILD for top chord member. So for remaining top chord member, just locate the opposite joint, moment at the opposite joint, A into B divided by L divided by H. Moment at the opposite joint divided by H. So maximum ordinate, and all these ILDs are looks like a triangle with maximum ordinate at opposite joint divided by H. So these three top chord members we have covered. You draw the ILDs for remaining top chord members. Now let's see how to construct influence line diagrams for bottom chord members. Now let us take ILD for bottom chord members. Now a typical, let's consider the member L2 L3. First let's consider member L2 L3. So L2 L3 is a bottom chord member, and again let's take a section 1 1 as shown in figure. Keep the same section because the section cuts the three member maximum. It also cuts the member L2 L3. Now we want to find out force in the member L2 L3. That means the unit load, once you just place left joint of the section and right joint of the section, and you find out, establish the relation between the force and the position of unit load. That means when unit load is on left of section, then you take moment about. Now here the other two members are this, and they are meeting at U2. So let's take moment about U2 equal to 0. Consider RHS. Here consider RHS since load is on the left. So while taking moment here, due to reaction it is anti-clockwise, and due to force in member should be clockwise. So we are considering right hand side. So this is anti-clockwise, and that means this is the nature. That is tension. Nature will be tension. So that is F L2 L3 into again H equal to. Now the reaction X by L into the distance is 5A into 5A. So this, the minimum value of X is 0, maximum is only A, up to left of joint is L2. That means X equal to 0, force is 0. So X equal to A, let's substitute FL2 L3 into H equal to, this is A into 5A divided by 6A, and this gives us maximum ordinate. So this is nothing but FL2 L3. So A into 5A divided by 6A is MU2 divided by H. That is moment at opposite joint divided by H. Here also the same expression we can use, moment at the opposite joint divided by H. And this moment we know A into 5A when the line of action of the load is at L2, means the line of action passes through U2. So divided by 6A into H is there. So ordinate is 5A divided by 6H, nature is tension. But here away from the joint, so nature is tension. So draw the ILD. So this is member L2, L3. And opposite joint is here, tension, therefore downward. And again you get the triangle only. So this is negative. And this ordinate is IUA by 6H. IUA by 6H. Now for remaining bottom part members, let's complete the ALEs. Say next member L1 and L2. Now here say what is the opposite joint U1. So F L1 L2 equal to M U1 divided by H, and nature is tension. That we know, bottom part members are in tension, top part members are in compression. Now when init load is here, what is distance A? 0. So actually this will be 0 into 6A divided by 6A into H, so 0 ultimately. So there is no force in member L1 L2. So ILE for L1 L2 is simply you keep this line. So no force in the member L1, L2. So moment at the opposite joint here will be always 0, and that's why the force in member is 0. So simply draw a line. Then next, let's consider next member L3, L4. Member L3, L4. L3, L4. Now for L3, L4, this is the opposite joint. So opposite joint is this. So that means our diagram will be like this. So this is the diagram, minus, and this ordinate is F L3, L4 equal to moment at opposite joint U3. M U3 divided by H. M U3 means this 2A into 4A. 2A into 4A divided by 6A into H. So this AA gets cancelled. This is 4A upon 3H tension. So this is 4A by 3H. Or A by 3H, ILE for member L3, L4. Now, I think remaining ILEs, so this ILEs we have completed. So, for remaining members, L4, L5, L5, L6, L6, L7, just locate the opposite joint. So, suppose L4, L5, so opposite joint is here. So, you just, what you do, directly you first draw the ILE. For bottom part, always tension, minus, and find out this ordinate. So this, that is F, L4, L5 is equal to, so U5, moment, here is 4A into 2A divided by 6A into H, same ordinate, 4A by 3H. Tension. So this is the ordinate. So then only two members are left. So for these two members, you draw the ILEs. Now let us consider vertical members. So top chord members, we have seen how to construct ILE. Bottom chord members, we have seen how to construct ILE. See, as far as top chord and bottom chord members are concerned, so locate the opposite joint. The maximum ordinate of ILE will occur the opposite joint, and which is given by moment at opposite joint divided by H. So top chord members are in compression, bottom chord members are in tension, and diagrams varies triangularly. So triangular variation. But in case of vertical members and diagonal members, we have to do the calculations. So such type of short calculations or formula is not available for that. So by using section method, by putting the position of unit load just left and right of the section, find out the ordinates and then draw the ILD. Means for top core, vertical and diagonal members, every time we have to do the calculations in detail. So let's consider the one vertical member. Let's have this vertical member. This vertical member. Say let's take a reference line and I am taking vertical member U2, L2. Upper chord members, lower chord members, accordingly the names are given. So here, to find out the force in this member, we have to take the section. How to take a section? So you take a section for this vertical member. So you take section this way. So it will cut maximum, say section 1-1. Three members and truss is divided in two parts. And again, when unit load is on the left joint of the section, apply equilibrium condition for right part. When unit load is on the right part, right joint of the, just right joint of the section, apply equilibrium condition for the left part. Means here, ILD for, say, ILD or vertical members. ILD for vertical members. Now let us consider first the member U2L2. Generally in the examination they ask to construct ILD for one top chord, one bottom chord, one vertical and one diagonal, or any two of them may be asked depending upon the assignment of the marks. So member U2L2 is vertical when unit load is on left of section. Just consider left joint of the section 1-1. Okay. Now here the other two members are horizontal and this is the only vertical. So apply summation Fy equal to 0. So which condition here we are going to use? Equilibrium condition. Fy equal to 0. Apply for RHS. Right hand side. Apply for RHS. So now on right hand side, this reaction is vertical. Force in the member must be downward. Means nature is tension away from the joint. So that is Fu2L2 is equal to X by L. Directly Fu2L2 must be equal to X by L and nature is tension. What is X? X just left joint. When X is 0, force is 0. Remember, here it is. And next is here, when X equal to A, force is Fu2L2. A divided by L is 6A, so this is 1 by 6 tension. Tension means negative. So here we just plot this. So this is 1 by 6. Next, when unit load is on right of section. Or consider right joint of right of section 1-1. Again apply summation Fy equal to 0 for LHS. Here you are.